Hello and welcome. My name is Paul Laidler. This video is about Plato and in particular a new feature called auto compilation. I'm also going to look at one or two other things on the way. For the new feature, you will need Plato version 5.3 and FTM95 version 8.62. And these can be downloaded via a link from the Silverfrost forum. Let's start with the clipboard ring. Plato automatically remembers what you put on the clipboard. And you can paste from that history by pressing Alt and V. Suppose, for example, I copy a number of different items, maybe these three lines. Just copy them with Control and C. Now, with a right click, if I select Paste from Clipboard History or use Alt and V, then I get a list of the history or recent items that have been copied to the clipboard. And I can paste any one of those by double clicking on that line. If it's a large amount on the clipboard, then you just get the beginning of what appears in that saved item. The clipboard history is stored in the clip library, and you can see it here as marked as the clip ring, and that's the content that you'll find. Moving on to the highlighting Fortran structures in the text. If I go to the settings dialog and select miscellaneous, then there's an item here called highlight matching Fortran do undo. When that's selected, the effect is that when we click on the beginning of click on a line that begins a Fortran do structure, then the beginning and end are highlighted with bold and underline. Click on the next line, and then on the beginning of that do, or the end of that do, then beginning and end are highlighted. The same is true for if then structure, beginning or the end, and the whole is highlighted in that way. And all of the Fortran structures have this highlighting feature. So that can be selected and used to make it easier to read the text. Right, let's move on to this main feature of auto compilation. I've got an example program here ready for you. Again, it's necessary to switch this feature on from the settings dialog. And this time it's auto compile FT95 code. And at the moment it's selected to be off. You can select it to be on or with different delays. I'm going to select every second, and that will switch on the auto compilation. And the effect of that is for Plato to begin a conversation with FTM95 compiler, which is running in the background. And Plato will take a copy. In my case now, every second will take a copy of the code and send it to the compiler, and the compiler will report back if and when it encounters a programming error. And it will only report the first error for you to use. Take, for example, this line here. Just to illustrate the idea, I should delete that bracket and see what the effect is. Then there is a delay because of the 1 second pause, but there is a report of an error shown, first of all, by a red box around that line. And then an icon appears, and when I hover over that icon, I get the reported error that comes up as a tooltip. And here it is unpaired left bracket, as you'd expect. So I can put that back in and make it correct again. Notice that that bracket is highlighted in blue anyway, and the corresponding opening bracket appears there. It's not only true for that, but of course also for nested brackets here, the closing bracket and highlighted with the opening bracket. Here, this one, the highlight appears. And finally, the innermost one, the highlight appears. That has to be also, that has to be switched on. And you'll find the setting is in the text editor and the general. A highlight matching brackets. And that's I switched that on. Let's have a look at another example. Suppose I delete this R, see what the effect is of that. Well, it comes up with an error report, variable name expected after comma. And so that trailing comma is not permitted. I can, for example, delete it. Now that leads to revealing another error, which is reported here. When I hover, R must appear in a type declaration because implicit none has been used. Incidentally, that same error appears down below in the status bar. As we look at the code, we find there is an implicit none, and so with that, R must be declared, and so we'll put it back to make the code right again. Now, the idea is that as we begin to write programs and type in new code, there will be that automatic interaction with the compiler, giving you a status report and the report of any compilation errors that are encountered on the way. In the end, we will normally continue to do an explicit compile, build and run, using, in my case here, I'm using this build toolbar, which is selected from the view menu. So there we have the basic idea, and it is quite a powerful way to work. If we have a look at a different example, we'll find that this time the error is that compiler can't find a definition for the module. Now, I've chosen to comment that module out just to illustrate that we do need the module. What Plato will do, and FDM95 in cooperation with Plato will create a temporary module when that's present. So here, if I comment out those three lines, then the module is actually present in the code. The compiler will find the temporary copy of the module and use it in the compilation. So that doesn't interfere with anything else that you might want to do in the normal way, that copy for the automatic compilation, that copy is just a temporary copy and is not used and not kept for anything other than this auto compilation. That means that if that module happens to occur in a different file, then you'd need to access that file first to create the temporary copy of the module, and then everything would work. As you, when you come back to this file, it would be found in its temporary location. So that illustrates the basic idea. Just one point to add, and that is that I haven't used a project here. I've chosen just to have a simple file with a direct compilation. And for that situation, there is an option to add extra FGM95 options on the command line. And here I've added FPP for conditional compilation, which I don't actually need, but you might need something like that, or you might need a wide source command, something which is required for that particular file, and you can provide that by this dialog, and that can stay open or closed at will, whichever you prefer. And the options which appear there, which need to be used in this auto compilation, they will be copied across and used by the compiler. So that illustrates the main ideas behind this auto compilation, and I certainly recommend that you give it a try, because you might find that it could be very powerful and very useful for you. So there, let's move on, and we're going to go on now to this illustration of debugging. I'll take go back to this program for that illustration, for that demonstration. Again, going back to the tools menu and settings, we find that you have the option to integrate Plato with the debugger. And when that option is selected, the Plato works directly with the debugging code. And in the case of 64-bit executables, when you're running for 64-bit, the debugging code is actually built directly into Plato and copied from the source for the SDBG debugger. So that being selected now means that when I start to run a debugging session, it will work directly with Plato itself. So here I've selected a debug option. I could also use checkmate. Both of those have debug features in them. And the code then will compile and link. And it can be run directly now from Plato. So when we start that up, we find that we have the debugging session has stopped at the first executable line. There's a window that shows the local variables. Also got the call stack comes up automatically. And using these buttons on the toolbar, we can step over. If there's a subroutine, we can step into the subroutine or out of the subroutine and continue to step in that way, looking at the code. Here we're calculating the value of an array, which is an array of complex numbers. We find that the values appear as we hover over a variable. You find the values appear in a tooltip. But down here in the locals window, you could add an extra watch window to watch into the particular variables. That would be can be added either directly by double clicking to give a new box with the variable in it, or we can right click and add to the watch. Variables can be stored here separately in a watch window. So let's just double click on N here. Here we've got, we see that the first value of N has been computed already. The others have not been evaluated yet. There's no checkmate on, so there's no undef value set, but the values that have been calculated are shown, and we can continue to step one line at a time, and you notice that the values appear and are updated as you go. We could, for example, stop the debugging and maybe run, click on the right mouse button and maybe go run straight to that point, run to cursor. That starts the debugger and goes directly to that particular point. We could select another line and toggle the breakpoint on that line and then run to that breakpoint. We could also look at all the breakpoints in a list. There's a breakpoint on line 15. We can also, as well as using this toggle breakpoint, we could, as an alternative, use the control and shift key. If we hold down control and shift and then click on that symbol on the icon, then that has the effect of toggling the breakpoint as well. So I shift and control click, and that creates a new breakpoint at that point, and then we can run to the breakpoint as before. In addition to that, we've got other possibilities, and if you really want to, you can look at the registers and see what's happening at the register level, or you can look at the assembly code and see how that's working, and look at that line by line. So all of these features you can get by running the debugger separately and independently, but almost all of the features available in the debugger directly can be are available from Plato itself in that way. So eventually we'll simply stop the debugger and continue with our development. That those breakpoints will be remembered for the next session if you want to keep them. So that illustrates a number of new features, and most importantly, this auto compilation, which could well be a very useful feature for you. So I encourage you to have a look at Plato if you don't already use it, and to have a go at using these features to see if you can take advantage of them. Well, that's all for now, and thank you for listening. Goodbye.